Hey guys, Dan Heilman back with another Eternal Evolution video. Today we're on the free-to-play account, and I want to show you my dungeon stage 15 full auto teams. I did this video on my main account, but this one's going to be kind of cool because I'm using some very low evolution heroes to clear stage 15 dungeons where before I could not. Quite interesting, actually. So I'm using a lot of summoners, which has made a lot of this possible, and honestly, they're not very high evolution. Let's just go look real quick at my roster. I do have a Senwei who is immortal, but for my other summoners, I have Skewer, haven't even unlocked the exclusive yet. I have Daniel only with a yellow border, and Mooka, I mean, I'm not using Mooka, but he is also not even unlocked the exclusive. So I think this might be a pretty cool video for some newer players who are having trouble with harder dungeons and don't have a lot of high evolutions, don't have a lot of triple S's. I think I only use like one triple S in these teams. So, all right, without further ado, let's go. So, Disa Caves, I think this one is by far the easiest. So I'll just kind of show you my team. Again, only one triple S in the team. You can see here, I'm using Serena to tank. This could be Masrani. You could also honestly probably put Ardis or Crete in here if your Serena is not EX20. And I just have the three free-to-play heroes. I got Sorieta, Botmark, and Taylor. And I have Emma. My Emma is exclusive 30, but does not need to be exclusive 30 for this team. You're definitely going to want to use Brynhild. Now, prototypes, you can use Redthorn if you want. You can use Vision Stone if you're using someone who debuffs. Again, those two are hard to get. If not, you can just use something like Praying Eyes, and that will work as well. So, okay, so here's the team. I will show you. It's pretty quick. I'll just use one stamina here. And just kind of show you. Now, if you really want, if your damage isn't quite up to par, you can manual tailor, jump him over to the right-hand side, and then put him back on auto, and he will attack the add. I need sound. I'm sorry. We need sound. Okay. But you can also, if you have enough damage, you can just out-damage the healing of the beetle. So that's what I'll do here. You can see if you have enough damage, you're just going to kind of push through even though the beetle is just healing the boss. It just slows it up a tiny bit. But again, I said these are full auto teams. You know me, I like the full auto. So I'll just, you know, it's only like a couple seconds. And honestly, I don't even know if it's any slower because when the tailor's over there, he's attacking the bug and not the boss. So I'm not quite sure, but... I guess we'll see versus my fastest team how quick this is. Boom, boom, boom. Emma obviously doing about double the damage as Taylor. Now, when Emma is only EX20, she does roughly the same damage as Taylor. So you can see EX30 seems to like almost double her damage. So Emma was my first EX30 on the account. So 39 seconds. Let's see what my record time is here. 39 seconds. Okay, so maybe it's even faster not even to jump Taylor over to the add if you have the damage for it. So, okay, there's Disa Caves. Now, Terra Dome is an interesting one because I made a spotlight on Senwei saying you can't use him here. And actually, he's really strong here, but like Taylor, you have to manual him. So let me leave myself right here. On stage 15, if I want to manual it, I can use... this team, except for I pull out Masrani and I put Senwei in the same spot and I manual Senwei. You can also use Taylor, but Senwei is actually kind of cool with using the summoner prototypes. But actually, I have a full auto team that works. And if you didn't know, stage 13 dungeons give you the exact same probabilities as stage 15. So 20, 23, 1.7, 20. It doesn't show you the other ones, but they're there as well. 20, 23, 1.7. You see what I mean here? It's weird because it actually shows that stage 15 doesn't give you... oh, I did 14, not 15. Oh, wait. Yeah, I did 14, not 15. Okay, so I probably can't do 15 here, but 13 is basically like doing 15. So it's not really clickbait when I said you can do all stage 15 dungeons. I can probably do it, but honestly, 13 is the same exact drop rate for everything, and it's a lot easier. So I'll show you the stage 13 team, and it's full auto, again, as I've been saying. Now, you can, if you need the extra damage from Senwei, you can put him in place of one of the healers, and you can manual him and manually put his summon inside the circle, just like you would do a tailor. But this team's kind of cool because it's full auto, and Daniel is only, look at the evolution of Daniel. It's quite insane. He is freaking... Look at my Skewer and my Daniel. Daniel, literally, I have two copies of Daniel, and I only have three copies of Skewer. So I don't even have their exclusives unlocked right now, and they're going to be able to kill this dungeon for me as basically the only damage dealers. So it's quite insane. It's not super fast, obviously, but it's full auto, and you're doing the highest drop rate dungeon here. Stage 13, you get all the prototypes, the same exact prototypes you would get in stage 15, the same exact catalyst cores that you use to level up the prototypes, the same exact advanced tickets. It's literally identical. I don't know why it's that way, because it's not that way for any other dungeon, but for some reason, Terra Dome 13 is the same as Terra Dome 15, as far as loot's concerned. You can see Daniel and Skewer doing decent damage. It's not super slow. It's not super fast. It's very consistent. So I think it's really cool. Again, I'm using the commander for summoners. And then Creed's in there tanking, and the summoners are doing decent damage. So summoners really have improved the game, in my opinion. You know, a summoner team is very viable in a lot of the content. Eventually, people will get that summoner prototype as well. Obviously, on my free-to-play account, I'm not able to clear 12. I think it's chapter 12 in Twilight. So I'm not able to do that, but no big deal. We're still able to make use of this team here. Not super fast at clearing these adds. Basically how these adds work is when the timer expires, they take a percentage of life off of your tank, which would be Crete in this. I don't know if it's like the last person the boss hit or how that works exactly, but here you go. Now all of my heroes are basically inside the circle. They're just going to finish off the boss. Easy peasy, summoner squeezy, you know? We might lose some people with that AoE. Nope. Hit Skewer, but didn't kill him. And there you go. I'll go over builds at the end of the video of all my heroes that I've used. But boom, 2 minutes, 26 seconds. You get the full amount of loot. No point in doing stage 15 unless you have a perfect auto team that does it quickly. Feel free to do stage 13. Okay, now Sunsaro Marsh. I was nowhere near in Sunsaro Marsh being able to clear it because I had mostly single target heroes, and then I tried this summoner team just like I did on my main team, and boom, magically I was able to do it. So placement's kind of important. If you want to leave Emma on auto, you want to put her here because it seems she runs right up and attacks the boss. Specifically, basically what I have here is a healer. Now you can use Serena in the middle. You could honestly probably use like Leo or a tank or just another damage dealer. Honestly, it probably doesn't matter that much. Again, I'm using Discar here. So Discar is going to be very useful because I'm using mostly summoners yet again. Prototypes don't really matter. Pick the one with the highest power or one that's going to work with Emma, right? So since I have Emma here, I can probably switch this to like Red Thorn or something like that, and it'll be probably be fine. The fight's not that long, so honestly, you don't get that much time to power yourself up. So prototypes don't really matter that much unless you're using someone that can use them, right? So, okay, those are the prototypes I'm using. And again, it's full auto. So we're going to use 5 stamina because I think I have one of the event quests to use 5 stamina here. And again, Daniel is only yellow, man. I only got 2 copies of him. So this is quite insane that I'm able to auto the hardest dungeons in the game right now with heroes that don't even have their exclusives unlocked. It's quite insane. The power creep from summoners has been pretty decent. And honestly, I think it's a great thing, especially for free-to-play players. People who can't even get... you know, some of the strong triple S's built very quickly, you can use this team pretty easily. I mean, Skewer is a triple S, Daniel's a triple S, but again, I only have 3 copies of Skewer. I only got 2 copies of Daniel. They do take a lot of damage when the eggs go off, but it doesn't really matter because there's enough people alive to finish the boss off. Senway is good here because he hits 3 targets, so even if he's attacking the wrong target, he's going to hit all 3 of them, right? 50 seconds, easy clear. Not high evolutions. Now let's go through all the heroes. We'll go through their gear. Now I do have decent gear on this account because this is a free-to-play account that I've had for a while. So I've been clearing Disa 15 for, I don't know, a month or more. So I'll just go through all the heroes I use and I'll go through their gear. So my Emma, she is in a gluttony set. If you don't have a gluttony set, just use her in all attack sets. And you're just going for as much attack as possible. Attack, attack, attack. And then you're going for attack. Ooh, that's a nice gluttony piece. It's funny because sometimes my free-to-play account has a lot better gear than my main account sometimes. Like, I don't have a piece this good on my main account for a gluttony piece with attack. I mean, look at that. Four rolls into attack, almost 15% attack just on that piece. Another good attack piece there. Okay, so she is my only exclusive 30 on my entire account. She does have her talents done because she is the most important character on my account. Kreet is my second most important character. He is exclusive 20. He has his talents all the way done besides the attack talents, and he's in a full HP set with one defense set, focusing on HP percent, damage reduction, and same for these stats: HP, damage reduction, HP, damage reduction, HP, defense, damage reduction. You guys get the point, right? Lots of damage reduction, lots of HP, and defense is kind of like a nice to have, but you want to prioritize HP and damage reduction first. Okay, so there's my Kreet. I use him sometimes. Senwei, again, you're going to prioritize just attack pieces. I don't even have ideal sets. Normally you would probably have attack sets, but it's hard to get a lot of attack sets with attack substats main stat, because you just need them on so many heroes. So don't forget that Senwei, he can give HP to his team. So it's okay to, you know, focus these HP sets as well. So attack, attack, attack. And again, HP is and defense are useful for him. He gives defense, right, to his little friends. Yeah, defense and HP. Okay, so he transfers defense, HP, and attack to his summoners, so that's that. I literally have no... I didn't even realize this, but I don't have a lot of talents on this free-to-play account. Talent points are hard to get. Literally no talents. The only one I grabbed is this one because it gives a heal every time for the shadow and himself. So that's pretty cool. We got Senwei going there. Who else do we use? I don't think... Oh, we use Serena, I guess, in Disa Cave. So I guess I'll just show her gear real quick. My Serena is EX20. She has her talents done, at least for the HP. And then she's in a healing set with HP sets. And HP, HP, HP. That maximizes her healing. If you have trouble with her survivability, you can put damage reduction here, but that means you get slightly less heals for the rest of your team. But if you need it to keep her alive, you can do that. Okay? So gear is not amazing on my Serena. I think I put a better set on my Maserati. I had to use attack sets here because, again, I'm looking for HP, but I don't have a lot of HP sets with HP. You guys want to see something crazy? I've been on this account for months and months and months and months. I only think I have one piece. Oh, I finally got a new piece after years and years and years. I only have one single HP percent helm with an HP set. So I actually finally got one. Do I have boots? I do have boots. Okay, so I can finally swap this attack set over. I'll do that off video. But sometimes it's hard to get those HP sets. I've even been smelting into HP sets and I still don't have it. So I don't think I use Kalaza in any of the teams. Did I use Kalaza? I'm not sure. But if you want to build Kalaza, you want to build a little bit of crit rate and pretty high crit damage. If you can afford a gluttony set on him, you can do that. But he stacks his crit rate over time. As long as you have unlocked the exclusive, even just the very first one, it says right here, the crit buff will no longer be removed when he crits. So it'll just stack to 100 automatically. Great summoner. You can use him in place of some other summoners if you don't have him. Say you don't have Daniel, maybe try him. Say you don't have, I don't know, Skewer, you can try him as well. In the Disa team, I did use Sorieta. Mine is exclusive 10. Equipment is just trying to get 60% crit and 60% crit damage and the rest into attack. So I'm just using a mixture of sets to do that. And that's my Sorieta. Talents are mostly done for Sorieta. I use her in a lot of content. Taylor, I use in a lot of content. He's exclusive 20 as well. He's kind of the same story. You want about 60% crit, 60% crit damage, the rest in attack. Yeah, so that's his gear there. It needs an upgrade. I haven't done his gear in a while. He does have full talents. I use Taylor a lot. One of my favorite heroes on the free-to-play. And then who else are we using in here? We are using Skewer and Hattie. Again, I only have three copies. I have some talents. Oh, I do have some talents done. I do have some talents done there. He's exclusive 0, obviously, because I can't even unlock it. And he's in full attack sets. Attack, attack, attack. Attack. bad piece, okay? So just full attack. That's his build. He's able to do this content even without unlocking his exclusive. So pretty cool there. And then Daniel is in, obviously, exclusive zero. He's only have two copies of him. I have him in pretty decent attack gear with attack and attack and attack and attack and attack and attack. You guys get the point. A lot of attack. Same thing for him. I think he gets HP and defense to his summons. Yeah, he does. No, just defense. Okay, so attack and defense go to the summons, and the HP of the summons is based on his attack. So you can get him attack, and if you have defense substats, that's fine for him. So that's that. That's pretty much the team. I just think it's a pretty cool team because I have such low evolutions on my summoners, and I'm still able to use them to clear the hardest content in the game. So I figured this might be useful for some newer players. If you enjoyed the video, hit the like and sub button. That's going to be it for the video today, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. Happy New Year, everyone. See you guys. That's gonna be it for the video today. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, hit the like and sub. Baby Lucas says, hey guys, hit that like and sub. Woo! All right, have a great day, everyone. See you guys.